Hello everybody! Here comes the latest news digest from RoboForex. Which events will be happening on financial markets on the first full-fledged week of July? First of all, it's important to mention that the second wave of the coronavirus pandemic is already here. So far, we can talk only about some particular regions in different countries. However, Kazakhstan already acknowledged this risk and is preparing for it with all the strength. The Russian economy hasn't been reopened properly after a self-isolation period yet. However, the published numbers are quite optimistic, looking as if they are going to plunge at any moment. The statistics from the USA and Europe look more stable, and the next week will offer a lot of data to pay attention to. Investors, and all of you invested in the subject, get ready! In this review, pound, yen, euro, which currency reacts to what and where it's heading? Statistics around the world in a few minutes. Europe, USA, Australia and Asia. Election race in the USA. What will happen with the dollar? Let's get started. First, a small overview of some national currencies. We will talk about the dollar a bit later. The pound. The United Kingdom continues fighting the European Union and logic while discussing and approving Brexit-related nuances, thus keeping the pound on its toes. The yen is exciting a rally in demand for safe haven assets. You never know what might scare market players. The euro is looking as if it is ready to rise, but investor sympathies are with the greenback due to both the statistics and attitude to risks. Well, now to our beloved statistics. This time we're expecting the data from all the main regions – Eurozone, Great Britain, USA, Japan, China and Australia. Let's start in order. The euro area is scheduled to publish several investing reports. For example, the retail sales, which plummeted by 11.7% in the previous month and it's expected to correct by a half. Right now, there are no active and carefree consumers in Europe, as the region is still suffering from the pandemic and observing safety precautions in society. Also, it will be very interesting to see the Centix Investor Confidence Index, which may recover up to minus 11 to 15 points in July. The indicator has been plunging since March and still remains negative, which shows that the pessimists still dominate the market. Next in the line, the USA. The country is ready to report on the consumer credit, which is anticipated to remain pretty minor because, as we said before, there is no room for consumer activity. It will be interesting to follow the PPI and the core PPI reports as they may provide insight into what is happening with the consumer prices as well. Unfortunately, there is no more interesting data from the USA this week, so let's move on to Great Britain. On Thursday, July 9th, the Bank of England will publish the FPC statement and the FPC meeting minutes reports. On the same day, investors will be offered the financial stability report. It seems that the British regulator won't take any sudden steps or expand its monetary tools until grave Brexit-related problems appear and the crisis due to the coronavirus pandemic gets more severe. The BOE's interest rate is 0.1% and the next meeting will take place in August 6th. For the pound, the less blurry the situation, the better. At the same time, the Reserve Bank of Australia will have a proper meeting next Tuesday, July 7th. Here, the benchmark rate is 0.25%, the lowest value, which just can't be cut any lower. The regulator will probably mention new cases of the coronavirus in the country and define relevant risks. But no one is expecting the RBA to say anything conceptually new. The Aussie is looking fine and the RBA's neutral stance may help it get stronger. In addition to that, there will be a lot of numbers from Japan and China, but the problem is that they are published late and do not fill in the whole picture. So, here we won't give any forecast, we just wait and follow the situation. Statistics, reports, coronavirus – these are great topics, but because of them, investors are losing sight of the election race in the USA. However, US President Donald Trump has reminded about it recently. The Twitter king and the master of volatility say that the third quarter of 2020 would be amazing for the American economy and deliver him an election win. As a rule, the USD's response to such statements is positive. And the last but not the least, cryptocurrencies. As some melancholy covered the cryptocurrency market, but we've seen this since a couple of weeks. In June, crypto investors were waiting for news from Ethereum on its 2.0 network, but nothing happened. so these expectations is postponed. Bitcoin offered a lot of small news of transactions and transfers, which has nothing to do with the major issue, scalability. However, solves this problem will skim the cream of the market, but alas, so far. Most likely, there will be something during the week that market players might find interesting. However, the current picture is quite busy. It's high time to devote yourself to midterm strategies and reshuffle portfolios. Stay tuned, or how else are you going to learn about the most important things? Just don't forget to subscribe to the channel, click the bell and give a video a thumbs up. See you on the RoboForex channel.